Hi, today I'm going to be giving you a bit of a tour of Connect, getting in, navigating the space, and a general overview of how it all works. Connect is TAFE Queensland's learning management system and provides students with a place to view unit materials, submit assessments, check their progress, contact their teacher, and more. It's also important to note that Connect is responsive and can be accessed through desktop, laptop, tablet, or mobile device. The content will reshuffle to ensure optimum display. Let's start with the My Homepage screen.
This is the landing page to get to all of the units that you are currently enrolled in. You'll see each of them represented by a tile that features an image and the unit name. For any overflow, there is a View All Courses button. The top bar or banner at the top of the screen is called the Minibar and makes navigating Connect simple and fast. The Minibar is always there regardless of where you are in Connect, although it may rejig a little due to the size of the screen you're working on. This has to do with that responsive design that we mentioned earlier. No matter the screen size, you'll always have the notification icons for communication, unit updates and alerts, and your profile information and settings. Here, you can edit your profile photo, change your email notification settings, and log out. Check out our Enabling Your Notifications guide for a more detailed breakdown of this area of Connect. The 9-squared icon, which has been nicknamed the Waffle, represents the unit drop-down menu. This allows you to access all of your units. You can pin your most frequently accessed units to the top of your list by clicking the pin icon. On a smaller screen, like a smartphone, this will sit underneath the menu icon as a set of three lines, often referred to as the hamburger. So, if you ever lose your waffle, you might find it inside your hamburger. Underneath your units will be the global announcements, where TAFE-wide announcements are displayed. This is usually info that's less specific to the units that you're enrolled in. It could be things like updates about Connect, TAFE Queensland competitions, or info about public holidays and campus closures. Further down from there, you'll see the TAFE Queensland footer, which includes some important links and information. Let's continue this tour inside one of your units. Front and center, we have the unit banner, which utilizes the same image as the tile that represented it on the My Home page. Next up is the announcements, which is where you'll see updates about your unit as you progress. Maybe a welcome message, hints or tips about your learning, available opportunities, reminders, or any other relevant unit news that you should be aware of. On the right, we have a number of handy widgets, starting with the updates area, which gives you a place to see what's new. Under that is the teacher contact widget, where you'll find the names, contact information, availability, and other relevant information about your teachers for this unit. Finally, there is the calendar, which will display events and dates, again related to this unit only. Next up, we'll head back up to the top and take a look at the navbar. The navbar is where you access unit-specific tools and resources. We'll cover these in depth in their own standalone tutorials. But the important thing to know is that you can access all your unit tools and resources through here. There is also a link to Connect Help, a quick and easy way to get help if you are ever stuck. Again, the responsiveness of Connect will mean that elements will adjust to better suit your different device screens. On a tablet, some of these navbar options might be compressed into a more menu. On a smartphone, they'll probably feature under the hamburger. This is all designed to ensure best possible user experience. Selecting My Unit Content in the navbar will take you to the content and activities that have been assembled and sequenced to make up this unit. The content area is a place where we can view and navigate through unit materials and activities through the left pane menu. Whatever we select in that menu will be revealed in more detail on the right. We can access the unit overview, any bookmarks we've made, any upcoming events. The number next to each heading will let you know how many items you still need to complete in each area. Let's now take a look at a single module. You can keep track of how far through the content you have progressed through this progress bar, just above the topic list. To make this work, you need to manually tick the boxes next to the modules and topics as you complete them. Let's select a topic and move through the module. Let's go to the last topic that has a tick next to it. If we have been recording our progress, this will be the last topic we visited. Here we have a page of content. We can bookmark this page by clicking the bookmark icon. The arrows let us move through the topics, either backwards or forwards. These appear at the top and bottom of a page of content. We can also use the slide-out panel on the left to give us instant access to the table of contents. We can use this panel to cycle through modules or to jump to the next topic. There are also breadcrumbs at the top of the page, which show us where we are. Let's tick this topic as completed, and then go back out to our overall module view. We can now see that we've completed that topic, and the number has decreased by one. Finally, by clicking on the logo, we can return to the Connect homepage, which we logged into at the start.